I'm back for round two on the draw, and this hand is pretty good. If I don't draw any creature, I'm unlikely to trade the Typhoid Rats because I'd like to cast the Living Totem on turn three. Okay, a Torch Fiend. I really don't want to trade with that, so hopefully my opponent just doesn't attack, because I will not be blocking. Okay, Crankbuzz Enforcer. I'll probably have to kill that. Alright, I'm very pleased that my opponent did not attack. This looks like another matchup where I'll be boarding in Fester Gloom. Okay, Belligerent Sliver is fine. Ooh, wow, and Hammer Hand. That's fine with me. I take 7 damage this turn, but next turn I just leave back all my guys and I shouldn't be taking any damage. And then the turn after that I'll kill the Enforcer and I should be pretty stable. I don't think there's much reason to attack. My opponent is being very aggressive, and I think my late game should be better. Especially with Sign and Bloods, I want to preserve my life total. Okay, just 2 damage here. Okay, and a Sliver Hive. Hopefully my opponent doesn't cast Constricting Sliver. Okay, I'm just gonna kill the Krankos Enforcer this turn. And then next turn I can play one of these creatures in a Sign of Blood. Okay, Swift Claw. That's not really a threat. I'll start off with the Shaman of Spring. Maybe not. Maybe I want to start attacking. Let me think about this. No, I should cast Shaman of Spring this turn. If my opponent attacks with everything, I still want to make a lot of trades. Ooh, Living Totem is interesting. I don't really want to tap down that much though, so I'm just going to cast Sign and Blood. Yeah, with all this late game in my deck, I would be very happy to just trade all of my creatures across. Okay, Pegasus, that will threaten me. A small amount. Ooh, Nightfire Giant is a great draw. I don't even know if I should cast Sign and Blood. It kind of opens me up to losing. I think that I want to cast a Nightfire Giant this turn. And maybe just not Sign and Blood. My hand's already great. And I think that I may as well cast the Living Totem. Let me tap. Actually, I'm a little bit concerned with tapping all my guys. I don't even know what to put a counter on, so I'll just cast the Totem next turn. I'm a little bit concerned about a constricting sliver coming if my opponent ever draws a six land, but hopefully we can avoid that. Ooh, Hammer Hand. That is pretty good. It makes the Pegasus not die, and maybe I'm taking some damage this turn. I'm glad I didn't cast the Living Totem, otherwise I would be taking a lot of damage. Alright, looks like I'll just be trading across. Figure out the best way to do this. Typhoid Rats on this. Two Shaman of Springs. Yeah, I think just blocking like this is best. Alright, we basically traded across, but I'm left with a Shaman of Spring. Ooh, restock. I can get back a Flesh to Dust. That will be good. Okay, what I'm going to do is, I don't have enough mana to cast the Flesh to Dust this turn, so I'm going to lead off with a Living Totem. I'm going to put a counter on Nightfire Giant and attack. I want to pressure my opponent as much as possible. And I still have this restock back. Never mind. I mean, I still have this Living Totem back to block. And attacking for 6 is no joke. So, I will attack. My opponent accepts. I'm pretty glad I didn't cast this Sign of Blood. I'm not in immediate danger. Gonna get back Flesh to Dust. And Living Totem, I assume. It's possible I should have just got Typhoid Rats and Flesh to Dust. My opponent doesn't have Lava Axe, this turn I should be in pretty good shape. Okay, Goblin Rough Rider. That does not concern me. Ooh, Stab Wound is great also. I could even put that on the Pegasus. So I have 8 mana. Yeah. So I'm not going to use the Flesh to Dust. I think that I'll just attack with Nightfire Giant. And, cast the Stab Wound on the Pegasus, and then leave up Flesh to Dust and Nightfire Giant, and my two blockers back. I think that is pretty safe. Yeah, I can't see losing to much else other than Lava Axe. I can even beat a Constricting Sliver this way. Okay, Heliod's Pilgrim. Let's see what this is. I can kill any of his creatures with Nightfire Giant in response to an enchantment, so not very concerned. Okay, my opponent selected Inferno Fist. Let's block with Shaman of Spring. Yes, let's just do that. Then at the end of the turn, think that I'll just start killing my opponent's creatures. My creatures are so big that it's better to just attack rather than have the Stab Wound kill my opponent. Okay, Cursed Spirit is good. Alright, I'm just gonna cast two Accursed Spirits. I don't really foresee a way for this to go too wrong. Like, just passing and using my Nightfire Giant or Flesh Dust actually seems more risky than this play. Okay, there's the Inferno Fist. Definitely block. Okay, and I've won this game. Okay, against this aggressive deck, Crippling Blight could be good, but I already have a bunch of early action. Fester Gloom could be good, and Plummet, I saw at least one target for in the Sungrace Pegasus. Titanic Growth is also occasionally good against these decks, against in response to burn spells or something like that. I don't think Plummet is fantastic when all I saw was a Sungrace Pegasus. All I saw for Fester Gloom was a Torch Devil, which I don't actually even care about. My deck seems like it is very well positioned in this matchup. I have lots of ways to trade, lots of big creatures, and card advantage. I could see cutting a Cursed Spirit. It is basically an unblockable threat that will kill my opponent, but it's also not particularly efficient when I'm behind. Okay, what I'm going to do is cut one Accursed Spirit for one. For one Fester Gloom. Just in case my opponent has triplicate spirits that I haven't seen yet. And I'll submit this for game two.